Well, let's start with Tony Abbott. He's accused Anthony Albanese and his ministers of snubbing Woodside's 70th anniversary party over the weekend. He says that not even Resources Minister Madeleine King, a West Australian, attended the celebrations for the gas producer because she was on leave. Tony Abbott said that gas is our second largest export earner and the only way to ensure that the transition to renewable energy doesn't put the lights out yet because it's an evil fossil fuel. And he says yet not a single Labor MP could attend this milestone. Zoe, what do you think? Is this a pretty rude snub?
It's extraordinary, right? So you have an entire slate of Liberal coalition MPs, former prime ministers there, celebrating this great Australian company, this great export, and yet no one wants to turn up because theoretically it's a fossil fuel. I went to COP27, the one that was held in Egypt a couple of years ago, and I met with parliamentarians across the political spectrum and across the planet. And every single one said to me, oh, climate change and energy, it's been conflicted in Australia. Hasn't it? And I said, well, to some extent, yes, but what's your solution? What's your baseload solution? What keeps the lights on in your country? Mm. And to a man and a woman, it was nuclear, number one, and gas, number two. And so there's not a fraught conversation. People just get on with keeping the lights on elsewhere. In my own electorate in Flinders, do you know how we're powered over summer? 8 diesel generators. Mm. We need to be honest about the energy sources we have now and what we're going to need to power Australian industry and the Australian economy in the future. Mm. Gas has to be part of that. There's no reason to treat Woodside like it's a leprosy colony.
Mm. But, Gary, it's not only that. As Tony Abbott says, Woodside has paid more than $40 billion in federal royalties alone. I mean, that's a lot to be grateful for when it comes to the budget and the economy.
Yeah, plus they're great ambassadors for Australia and upteen economies that need our gas. You know, nobody from the Federal Labor Party went along to Dealers and Diggers. That's the big gathering of all people in all of the resources. So it's not just simply those who are involved in carbon industries. It's all of the resources industry. I mean, I thought Madeleine King was a courageous appointment. She's the Minister for Northern Australia and she's in Southwest Western Australia. This mob are completely out of touch. It's all about the factions and it's all about trying to appease those lefty, greeny elements who want to kill off carbon. And I'm from Queensland and just a few hundred kilometres north and northwest of where I am right now is the world's greatest supply of that beautiful black stuff, coal. The first four letters of the word coalition. And I got to tell you, we got to keep using that coal to keep the power on because Victoria's going to need a lot more diesel generators based on everything I've seen about its future electricity needs. We just need to produce more and more electricity at cheaper and cheaper prices, like we used to do about 40 years ago when we were growing our economy. This mob have got no idea at all.